some sound with a rude boy ting.
Hey, what is up YouTube? How you all doing? So today I thought about doing a full day of eating because we are really, really close about getting into the growth season. So I just want to show you guys a little gap between prep right now and the growth season. So first things first, everything starts with the morning routine that I'll show you guys in a couple seconds, and let's get started. Alright guys, so this is the little morning routine that I've been doing ever since the show. I haven't stopped doing any cardio since the prep because I'm really into it. And in order for me to do my morning routine, everything starts at night. So I prepare my shaker. Once that is done, I have my clothes already there, so I don't have any decisions to do. I just gotta get in the room, get my clothes on, everything ready, and then I can start my morning cardio. So there won't be any pussiness getting into my head in order to get me not doing my cardio. So cardio has been steady. Why? Because I love it, and after prep, you become an athlete, so you just wanna keep that stamina going. I started to stretch my quads because my knee still really hurts as hell. So I gotta make sure this is under control to grow my legs. And I train my forearms in the morning now because I've noticed the better my grip, the better the control I have on my lifts. So the better control, the better results. And especially when you try to grow a back, you wanna have a better control into just holding and pulling with your elbows. So if this can hold, I won't have any mental problem just thinking about holding the weight. So forearms, stretching, cardio, this is a morning routine. So once that is done, I get my meal number one and show you guys right now.
It's a lot harder to do filming myself. This is every supplement that I take in the morning.
In order to make an oatmeal taste good and make sure that you follow the oatmeal every single day, everything happens in the blend. I put some chia seed in there because it's really high in fiber, calcium, and omega-3s. Really important in terms of health. And everything in terms of fibers, I'm really into it because the more fiber I have, the better digestion I'll have. And the amount of food that I'm eating, I have 15 grams by the way, it's really important to have nice quality fibers in my body. So like I told you guys, this little supplement is really special in terms of digestion. It's pretty much one of the best out there. I put 2 scoops of that. And you know, I'm all about my pink salt into my oatmeal just because the flavor is amazing and you can't go wrong with pink salt. I put also potassium because my body reacts well to having higher potassium because I'm a water buffalo. I got my best friend cinnamon with me. I put as much as I can because I'm in love with that flavor. And for protein, try to get something that is really flavory. So I got my glazed donut, and for now, nothing has beaten glazed donut. If you have a better flavor than this, DM me. I'm really confident. So this is my meal number one. I'll put the calories right there. Now I just blend this beautiful mix and then I'm gonna eat this beautiful dish and then skip to meal number two. All right, so onto the coffee. The coffee is a very important part of the day for most people, and most of my clients usually put sugar and milk in their coffee, and sometimes they don't even tell me, and then that's why they're not losing any weight. So what I do into drinking my coffee and getting shredded, first of all, we just got this Nespresso machine. All right, for us, this is brand new. So we've been having fun with buying some, you know, little cups and stuff like that. So right now, caramel is our favorite one, but we don't just stop there because yes, this is flavored, but this is not as good as we want. So what we do, first of all, We got cashew milk. Almond milk works really fine. We got this little machine that came with the Nespresso machine. So you just fill that beauty up. And what we do is put one scoop of flavor back. They have different flavors, but we've tried them all. And personally, chocolate is 15 times better than every other single one. Vanilla is pretty good as well, but chocolate is, it's GG. So I put one scoop in here, it's pretty much done. So I'll put what I have here. And if you can just zoom in, it mixes itself. So it creates hot chocolate. And then the machine is just gonna do what it does. And the coffee is incredible. So if you haven't tried this technique before, and you say your coffee isn't good without sugar and all of that, you're lying. All right guys, second meal of the day is the plain old bodybuilding meal, chicken and rice. In order to make my chicken and rice tasty, I use sauces. As you know, I love my zero calorie sauces, low calorie sauces, and spices. So what I do in order to have chicken and rice every day, because most people are like, oh, I don't have the time to, whatever. Once I get home, I just cut everything down. I'll just show you guys right now. So I cut it everything into little pieces. Once that is done, every morning I want to wake up after the morning cardio, I put everything into the air fryer. It's already nice and made, so this portion is gonna last me over a day. Afterwards, I do this every morning, so the time that this is cooking, I have the time to do my meal number one. So when that is done, I have chicken for the rest of the day. For rice, really simple. Right here, crock pot. What I do, I put a lot of pink salt into the mix, so it tastes really nice. I love jasmine rice. So this meal is 350 grams of rice, 200 grams of chicken, and I'll show you guys the little sauces for this meal. So when it comes to sauces, I have the number one, ketchup, low sugars. And right now, the one that I'm really in love, actually the number one sauce that I'm really in love with right now, I don't have it at home because I just eat it all the time and I forgot to buy some more. But my second one, I don't know if it's gonna focus. It probably won't focus. It's the classic ranch. It's some yogurt, 30 calorie sauce. It tastes so freaking good. It made me fall in love with chicken and rice all over again with that other sauce. So in order to follow your diet, you gotta love what you eat. So sauces for me are the way to go. And you can make anything taste good with chicken and rice if you put the effort into the sauces, the spices, and all of that. So the pre-workout meal, I love my cream of wheat. The main reason why I eat this pre-workout is because for the amount of food it takes to carb me up, it's really nice and light. So in the gym, I'm never bloated. And most of the times when I used to eat like, I don't know, like a full meal like chicken and rice, I used to burp during my workout. It wasn't digesting the right way. But this, I'm putting 120 grams of cream of rice. And it's like 4 spoons just to eat it all. So it's a lot of carbs for the amount of food. So I do this. Afterwards, I got my almonds because I feel like my body reacts well to having fat pre-workout meal. And one scoop of protein because having a bit of protein pre-workout is always important. Well, that's it for the pre-workout meal. I usually do something else with honey when I do leg days. And what I wanted to tell you guys, this full day of eating is only when I train chest, back, and shoulders. When I do arms or I rest, I fast in the morning. I'll explain that later on in the video, but I fast and my calories are a lot lower and they're a lot more on fats than carbohydrates. So I'll explain that later, but that's it for the pre-workout meal. All right guys, so we just got back from the gym. It was an awesome chest and shoulder workout. I usually do chest and triceps, but I don't really need that much triceps instead of my shoulders. I need a lot of delts in order to win a pro card. So now I do chest and shoulders. I will explain everything, my split, all of that in my next video. So my post-workout meal is the meal that I was craving the most during prep. Salmon. I'm in love with salmon. I don't know why. The taste is so freaking good. And also, what's awesome about it, it's healthy as hell. It's one of the best fats you can eat. So I do 200 grams of salmon, 400 grams of white rice, and I put lettuce in there, and it's just completely amazing. So sorry about that. So that's meal number, what are we, 4? So yeah, I'll show you guys. It's nothing too crazy, but yeah, I love my salmon because how much omega-3s they have in there. Everything that is good for my heart, I'll take it. So there you have it, guys. Nothing too special. Beautiful rice, beautiful lettuce right here. So something I really wanted to tell you guys is that on this day, on chest days or back days, I have my carbs way higher. This year, I'm taking things a lot different. I'm doing some carb cycling in order to not get used to eating a lot of carbs and not getting too fat in the off season. So on this day is my most calorie wise day. So I'll put the calories at the end of the video and also explain the calories that I eat on a rest day and calories that I eat on other days. So this is my highest calorie meal. But like my metabolism is going really crazy right now, I will probably add 200 calories every week, see how it rolls. If you want to know if your calorie, if your metabolism is really active, it's really simple. Eat the same meal, weigh yourself, and are you gaining weight? Are you losing weight? If you're gaining weight, you don't have to add much calories. And if you're losing weight, that's it. Then you can finally start adding more calories. That means your metabolism is really crazy. I started at 3,000 calories. After prep, I was like, all right, I'm gonna just stay on 2,900 calories and just, you know, cruise here and see how my body flows. And I was doing that, and I was getting leaner than when I was on stage. And I was like, this is not what I'm looking for. So I went to 3,400. I was still losing weight. I went to 4,000. I'm like, hell, fuck it. I'm gonna just go to 4,000 and see how it goes. And I was just getting a bit of weight. And after a week, my body was starting to lose weight. My metabolism started to attack crazy. So then I went to 4.2, and it went, you know, everything kind of felt better. And now it's starting to lose some weight again. So now I went to 4.6 just to say fuck it. And finally, now I'm gaining a bit of weight, but still, it's slowly gaining. So that means I'm on my right spot. So that's it for the post-workout meal. Catch you in the next meal. All right, guys, so we're meal number 5. This is where I used to have a lot of problem eating. I don't know if you guys remember, but before this prep, my hunger was none. For 2 years, couldn't eat much. So I don't want the same thing happening this year. So on meal number 5, I have pasta. Pasta is really good with the way my body digests foods. I don't know why, but it's probably the carbohydrates that bloats me the least. So I love myself some pasta at night. And the way that I do it is I put the leftover salmon that I cooked earlier, the giginess, and I put 100 grams of nice chicken in there. Look, you see how beautiful this chicken is? That is called the air fryer. That's right, that's what's up. So on this meal, what I'm gonna do, I'll just keep eating pasta. One, because it works great with me. Look, if you wanna know if a good carbohydrate works with you, notes, first of all, you gotta note stuff. Eat like 100 grams, see how you feel. Are you bloated? Are you tired? Do you feel energized? And if it works well, there you go. It works well with you. So this is meal, I think, number 5. And yeah, so really simple, tasty, and I love it. I don't know if you guys noticed, but every meal is in a bowl. That's, you know, you eat, you know you're a bodybuilder when you eat in a bowl. It's simple, you can put as much quantities as you want. It's not fancy, it's the way to go. I guess for my last meal of the day, I take my oats and my isolate protein separate. The reason why I do that is because with my isolate protein, I make pretty much an ice cream. The main reason why I love taking an ice cream at night is because it cools me down and it helps me go to sleep. And I love my oats at night because it just makes me full and makes me want to sleep as well. Because as you know, sleep is very important in terms of gains. So I make sure to make my sleep very, very up there, very important. So I have this ice cream. What I do with my ice cream is nothing really special. We got cinnamon, We got 2 scoop of isolate protein. We got a bit of Aixam gum in there. We got a lot of ice, and we got almond milk. And that's pretty much it. I'll show you guys the consistency afterwards. And for oats, I have 130 grams of oats for my night. So that's about it for the full day of eating. I'll show you guys my total calories somewhere after this clip. So thank you guys for watching. Catch you in the next one. This is what I'm looking for my ice cream.